Disclaimer, this channel and all its videos are meant for a PG-13 audience. With that out of the way, enjoy the video. Thomas Friends has had a lot of books. We got the Railway series, magazine books, and even a manga. But one series of books I haven't talked on my channel are the Thomas Friends annuals and the characters that appear in those annuals. But before we go over the characters, let's go over what the annuals were and what their purpose was. After the Railway series was published, they decided to group stuff like real-life stories about real locomotives, coloring books, and stories from the Railway series, and even some original stories in these annuals. These were basically meant to celebrate what Thomas did throughout the year. At least that's how I've always interpreted them. The annuals have mainly just been a fun little look back, and the coloring pages look pretty fun. There are some interesting stories with new artwork to get you to actually want to buy this annual besides just having another Thomas item in your house. Basically, the annuals are meant to look back at Thomas's history and kind of throughout the year. It's basically an activity book. This has been a neat little tradition, even going up to 2022, but in 2023, it's going to be replaced with Long Johns Ago, and yeah, that's just disappointing. I wish it wasn't like that, but it makes sense. I get it, corporation thing, but kind of stinks. Now since I'm done being a drama queen, let's get into the actual characters. First, we have Algy. Now, Algy has two very different designs. His first appearance has him breaking down at a traffic light.
You're not making a great first impression on me.
He was taken over for Birdie while he was sick, but he should know that no one can replace Birdie like that. Especially on your first day, like, that's just money down the drain for Stump Hat. In his second appearance, which I have a very hard time believing this is the same character, what did they do from the last bus? Just take the face and put it on a new bus? Is that possible? Is that like surgery? Anyway, in his second appearance, he actually helps Duck's passengers and delivers them successfully, and I guess all it took was becoming blue and having a huge redesign to your bus. Next, we have the Living Thompson. Now, it wasn't really given any character, it was mainly just there to be kind of neat, but basically it goes over its real life history and just kind of puts it into the Thomas universe as a character. Next is David and Danny. David and Danny were two twins Thomas couldn't tell apart, so he went to the only twin engines he knew, Donald Douglas and Bill and Ben. They helped Thomas on telling the two apart, which, that's a great story idea, and I think that'd probably be a fun story if it was an episode. Next we have Prince. In the book Prince appears in, it says, the Prince, or Prince as he's later known, is the oldest working engine in the United Kingdom. He was built in 1863 by George Eaglin. It's a little different from its real life history, but that's kind of cool. Next is Bob Punch and Judy Man, which Bob's a puppeteer, but like the main reason why I included this is because like look at the face, like that is just not Thomas. I don't even know what that is. Like who do they get to draw that? That's just a weird cartoon. It's not even the style of Thomas humans. Like yeah, the Railway series had like more realistic humans, but like still, that's just, that looks real cheap there. Next we have Rivermite. Now Rivermite isn't given any original backstory or anything like that. It's basically just the real life history of the locomotive. But one thing that happened in real life with Rivermite is it actually dressed up as a mic for a day with Thomas, and that's so cool. Like that's so neat. I really think that's nice. Next we have Henry's Fireman, but he's given a name in the annual. And you'll never guess what that name is. Are you ready? Get your hopes up for it, because you're gonna be disappointed. It's Ted. Yeah, they named Henry's driver Ted. Out of all the names you could have chosen. If you're a Ted watching this video, just know you're a legend, and the only reason I'm mad about this is because they could have chose like any other name that wasn't that popular. And finally, we have the elderly brake van. This van's only appearance is talking to trucks about engines that were named after racehorses, which I guess trucks and brake vans just have to talk about stuff because it must be very boring being a truck and having to be pulled everywhere. And that will do it for today's video. Now, if you want to stick around a little longer, I will be having a little discussion just about a project I'm working on at the end of the video. But to get all this out of the way, thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the video, consider subscribing because it really helps with the channel. We're pretty close to hitting 3K, and I would hopefully like to get that soon. Thank you all for watching again, and I'll see you all another time. Goodbye. So, it's been a while. These 2-week uploads have been pretty nice and just fun to focus on other stuff, actually. I know y'all aren't used to me hanging out at the outro for this long, but I do have some neat things I want to talk about. First off, thank you all for the support on the channel. I am really appreciating it, and I'm liking this new style of videos and the weeks I have in between. It's really nice, and it gives me a lot more of a creative break. Another thing I want to announce is that I have a project I am working on with a team of mine, Roblox related, but I'm pretty excited to announce it soon. It will probably be announced next video-ish, if that's alright, or maybe just a solo trailer. I'm not too sure yet, but that's really where I've been putting all my time into, and that's why this video didn't come out like a day earlier. But that's all I really have to say about this, and I'm probably gonna go to bed soon because it's like 1 a.m, but let me know if you want me to do these little talks at the end of videos. It kind of makes it feel more personal. Then again, I don't really want to rip off the paint of your jester. Go subscribe to him, by the way. Pretty good friend of mine. But yeah, let me know if you want me to do these talks at the end of videos. Just make it feel more personal, and I'll see you all next time, because this outro went on for way too long.